Hey guys! So, ignore the quality of this first clip because I'm filming my intro to my bookshelf tour on my webcam. I filmed the whole bookshelf tour on my camera and I've already edited all that, and then I realized I didn't film an introduction. So I'm filming this introduction real quick. The rest of the quality of the video will be a lot better, I promise. I'm splitting this into two parts. This first part is my first bookshelf that I normally film in front of. And then the second part that'll be released later is the bookshelf that you normally don't get to see. I just finished rearranging them, and literally I could not fit another book on my bookshelves right now. But I hope you enjoy this. And I apologize because I have the tendency to show you the book and take it away before I finish speaking. My bad. But I hope you enjoy this, and I'll see you later. Bye! This is a quick overview of this first shelf. And this shelf, a family friend made for me when I was very little, and I've had it forever. The first thing I have here is this really old globe of my dad's that we found when we were cleaning out his old house. And it says, "This heart of mine was made to travel this world." Underneath it right there is a little rock that seems kind of irrelevant, but it's actually from La Push Beach. My grandma went there a couple years ago and brought that back as a souvenir. Bottles, I tend to collect bottles like this, so I have a Stewart's and a Fanta. Here we have this little handmade heart box. I'm not completely sure where it came from, but my grandma got it somewhere. She travels a lot. Next to it is this V for Veronica, and it has a violin in it. She got that for me when I was really young. Next to it is one of the little Russian like box doll things. The name for them is escaping me right now. But that's actually from Russia, and a guy who runs the photography club that I'm in, his wife brought that back for me because she knew of my obsession with Russia. Right here, this little spoon is from Switzerland. My grandma got it for me there. Right here is a mahogany teakwood candle, and if you do not have a mahogany teakwood candle in your life, you need one because they smell like boy models, and it's lovely. Next to it is a little glass sculpture that my aunt got me at a museum in Florida. It's some art sculptor guy who's really, really famous. And then here is just a little miniature fake aquarium bottle thing from St. Thomas Island. And next to it is this really cute mason jar that my friend made for me. She took it and she put water and glitter in it, put this picture of us in there from New York, and put a bow around it. And then in the back, it has this big reflection that has a scripture in it. It says, "Stay beautiful, love, Taylor." Here is my lamp, and on it I have this sticker from, or not sticker, pin from my drama club. And on the lamp I have this little magnet that says laugh, and I really love that. And then back there is a flashlight, a Coke bottle that's actually from the World of Coke, which is where they make Coke. And then next to it is Share a Coke with Veronica. Somebody actually found that for me, and I was really surprised because I never expected to find my name on one of those. And then there's a little Diet Coke can next to it. And then next to that is a jar where I keep my extra change, and I'm planning on saving that up for my first tattoo. It'll probably take me a long time, but I still have 2 years, a year and a half. So, and that jar is from Dick's Last Resort. And the final thing up here is this picture frame that says friends on it, and here on the left it's a picture of me, my friend Shelby, and my friend Sophie, and that's on Tybee Island. It's in Tybee Island on the beach. The middle one is of me and my friend Haley at the Heavy and Light event in Nashville, Tennessee, sponsored by To Write Love on Her Arms, my favorite organization. And then the final one is of me and a bunch of people in my youth group at church. On my first shelf here, I have this framed autograph from Ian Desmond, the shortstop for the Washington Nationals, and it's on my ticket to that specific game. Next to it is this little music box that is from Switzerland, and it plays a really pretty song, and it's painted really nice. Next to that, this is a mason jar that has a bunch of my books in it that I have not read yet, and so if I'm in a major reading slump and can't decide what to read, I'll pull one out of here. But I don't decide all of my books by that. My next thing here is this little mason jar that my friend made me. She put little stud things on it, and there's a little fake candle down in there that I can turn on and light up, and it gives a nice little soft light. And this third jar right here is a memory jar, and in it I just put things that have made me really happy or that I really enjoyed in this year of 2014, and at the end of the year I'll open it up and read them. And then there's some random rocks and seashells and stuff down in the bottom. Use the shadows, but the final thing up here are some bookmarks, this little doll that my mom got me when I was really little, and this is a ticket to the Celebrate Freedom event in Atlanta, Georgia, and it's signed by all of the members of Family Force 5. This first little section right here is my classics. Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen. I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings by Maya Angelou. The Great Gatsby by F. Scott Fitzgerald. Charlotte's Web by E.B. White. Sarah Plain and Tall by Patricia McLaughlin. A Brave New World by Aldous Huxley. The Bell Jar by Sylvia Plath. Jane Eyre by Charlotte Bronte. The Secret Garden by Frances Hodgson Burnett. And since it's too big to stand up on the shelf, Les Miserables by Victor Hugo. Emma by Jane Austen. Next we have books in a series that I only own one book in that series, and they are listed alphabetically. Of Poseidon by Anna Banks. Shadow and Bone by Leigh Bardugo. White Cat by Holly Black. Graceling by Kristen Cashore. The Selection by Kira Cass. Misguided Angel by Melissa De La Cruz. Wither by Lauren De Stefano. Angel Fall by Susan E. Just One Day by Gail Forman. Eon by Allison Goodman. Gone by Michael Grant. Burn for Burn by Jenny Hahn and Savon Vivian. The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo by Stieg Larsson. Legend by Marie Lu. Monument 14 by Emmy Laybourne. Cinder by Marissa Meyer. Dairy Queen by Katherine Gilbert Murdoch. The Adoration of Jenna Fox by Mary E. Pearson. Across the Universe by Beth Revis. Under the Never Sky by Veronica Rossi. Small Steps by Lewis Sacker. Slated by Terry Terry. The Hobbit by J.R.R. Tolkien. And The Program by Suzanne Young. This next shelf is standalone books, and I don't have any other books by the author. Speak by Laurie Hall Sanderson. The Future of Us by Jay Asher and Carolyn Mackler. Two-Way Street by Lauren Barnhold. Ant's copy of Guy in Real Life by Steve Bresnahan. Da Vinci Code by Dan Brown. The Perks of Being a Wallflower by Stephen Chbosky. Someone Else's Life by Katie Dale. Marley and Me by John Grogan. Buddy by M.H. Herlong. The Kite Runner by Khaled Husseini. 5 Summers by Una Lamarche. The Screwtape Letters by C.S. Lewis. We Were Liars by E. Lockhart. Jeremy Fink and the Meaning of Life by Wendy Moss. Wonder by R.J. Palacio. Suzanne's Diary for Nicholas by James Patterson. The Silver Linings Playbook by Matthew Quick. Confessions of a Teenage Drama Queen by Dean Sheldon. Charlie St. Cloud by Ben Sherwood. The Lovely Bones by Alice Siebold. What Goes Around, which is a bind-up of Cracked Up to Be and Some Girls Are by Courtney Summers. Arcadia by Mandana Tawedi. It's Kind of a Funny Story by Ned Vizzini. And The Distance Between Us by Casey West. Next on this shelf we have my nonfiction and my historical. Righteous Pursuit by Neil T. Anderson and Dave Park. Jesus is Greater Than Religion by Jefferson Beth. Crazy Love by Francis Chan. On the Tip of My Tongue by David Gentle. They Say I Say by Gerald Graff and Kathy Bergstein. Staying Strong by Demi Lovato. Reflections by Roan Writers Group. I'm Going to Be a Zebra by Peter Nevland. The Story. The Story of Jesus. Water for Elephants by Sarah Gruen. Between Shades of Grey by Ruta Sepetys. Abraham Lincoln Vampire Hunter by Seth Graham Smith. Stardust by Neil Gaiman. The Book Thief by Marcus Zusak. Labor Day by Joyce Maynard. Extremely Loud and Incredibly Close by Jonathan Safran Foer. This bottom shelf contains my Nicholas Sparks collection, my Stephanie Meyer collection, and my J.K. Rowling collection. The Longest Ride. True Believer, A Walk to Remember, Nights in Rodanthe, The Rescue, A Bend in the Road, Safe Haven, The Best of Me, The Notebook, Dear John, The Wedding, The Lucky One, The Last Song, and At First Sight, all by Nicholas Sparks. The Host, The Twilight Saga Official Illustrated Guide, Twilight, New Moon, The Short Second Life of Brie Tanner, Eclipse, Breaking Dawn, and The White Version of Breaking Dawn, all by Stephanie Meyer. And finally, over here in the dark corner, I have my Harry Potter section with some Harry, Hermione, Ron, another Harry figurine, but I'll remove them so we can get past them to see the books. There is J.K. Rowling, The Wizard Behind Harry Potter by Mark Shapiro. And this is a biography, an unauthorized biography, and it kind of sucks because I think in like the first 5 pages they get her birthday wrong and I'm like, what? But it's here anyway. The Tales of Beedle the Bard, Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban, Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire, Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix, Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince, Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows, Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone, Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone. We have Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. My paperback copy that actually has a cover is being loaned out right now. Back copy of Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire, all by J.K. Rowling.